My name's Mickey Ransom. I'm professor of soil science in the Department of Agronomy at Kansas State University. We're out here today on the Rannells Flint Hills Prairie, and this is a field trip that we're running associated with the Soil Science Institute. 3-week-long workshop for training for some of the professional soil scientists. And we have professional soil scientists from all over the U.S. here. There are 16 of them. 15 of them work for the USDA Natural Resources Conservation Service, and one works for the Bureau of Land Management in the Department of the Interior. We're looking at a soil pit here. The soil series is called Konza. It's a soil that's fairly extensive on some of the broader ridgetops here in the Flint Hills. And we have a pit dug that's about 6 feet deep that we're showing them some of the different soil properties. And really this gives an opportunity for them to see out here in the field some of the things that we've been talking about back in the classroom and in the laboratory. We've had lectures related to pedology, soil classification, soil genesis, soil mineralogy, also soil biology. We've had topics on soil fertility, soil chemistry, soil quality. They've had a lecture on geomorphology, so they're getting an all-around overview of some of the topics that would be important to a professional scientist.
My name is Neil Martin. I'm a soil scientist with NRCS, Natural Resource Conservation Service, and I work in Findlay, Ohio. We're here at the Soil Science Institute. Most of us are mid-career or somewhere in that area, and we're trying to brush up on our knowledge of all things soils, chemistry, soil biology.
My name is Dylan Gray. I'm from Knoxville, Tennessee. NRCS, I guess they like to structure. They like us to come mid-career and sort of get a science refresher. This is hands-on. You know, this is all that stuff that we, all the little things, all the little pieces of the puzzle that we forgot. You know, we all know what happens with when carbonates precipitate, but we don't really know how it happens. You know we can identify them, but we don't. If we've got the formula in our heads, then we can kind of tell what's going on. So. It gives us a lot more scientific context. Where this is already just a week and a half, I feel empowered in a sense. It might be a bit dramatic, but you get confidence in this. Your confidence sort of gets eroded when you're just out doing field work, when you're running transects and when you're digging in the dirt, and you're making descriptions like this. You don't need to make a description like this. You really don't need much but like a knife and your field book and your eyes and your experience and that kind of thing, even though all these words are very technical sounding. I would recommend to any soil scientist mid-career that Soil Science Institute be a major part of their learning plan, a definite part of their learning plan.
My name is Jessica Jobe, and I'm from Kerrville, Texas. I've been with NRCS for 8 years now. Some of the soils that we see here in Kansas are similar to the soils that we have in Texas. And so seeing what people are doing here on the land in Kansas is something that we can take back and use in Texas as well, and maybe help landowners with new ideas that maybe they're doing here in Kansas that we're not doing in Texas yet. I went down into the pit to look at the soil structure and the different components of the soil, the texture, color, which gives you a good indication as far as organic matter is concerned, calcium carbonate, like lime, and then salts, which could have a huge impact as far as plant production is concerned. So those are the types of things that we're looking at when we go down in the pit and describe the different kinds of soils. As far as our work with Kansas State, it's critical as to NRCS so that we have the best knowledge and the most current knowledge and information that we can pass on to the producers so that they're all up to date and we're not using 50-year-old practices. It's critical for us to know what kind of research is going on, and Kansas State has done a really good job keeping us informed as far as what's going on and the kinds of things that they're learning with their research.
It's all part of a cooperative organization that's called the National Cooperative Soil Survey that really involves the different federal agencies that work in the soil survey program. That would be the Natural Resources Conservation Service, Bureau of Land Management, Bureau of Indian Affairs are also involved with the soil survey program, the U.S. Forest Service, and then various state agencies. Usually the land-grant university in each of the states also cooperates with the National Cooperative Soil Survey. And Kansas State University, K-State Research and Extension, we're one of the cooperators. It's an honor for us to have an opportunity to host this workshop.